popping. It's Justina Valentine, and you already know what it is. It's tea time with your girl, Justina Valentine, every Sunday night, 6:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And you guys are not going to believe who I found in the lobby of the hotel. This is insane. He's got a flight to catch, but D, Big D, can I call you that?
Yeah, you can call me that.
Can you just say hi to the people real quick?
Hello, hello, hello. This is Denzel. I am so happy to be here. It's a pleasure to be looking across from the Queen and wilding out, and everybody that's involved with the production. I commend you guys and I salute you.
Wow, I cannot believe I ran into the Denzel Washington. This is insane. So what, you know, I know you have to go. I know your Cadillac Uber's outside.
Hey, that's fine. Hey, I got time for you, Justina.
what's the favorite, I mean, you've done so many classics. What's your favorite movie that you've started?
My favorite movie, actually, I don't know if a lot of people know about this movie. This is my first movie I did. This is, it's called Ricochet. That's right. I was a cop. I was a young cop, and I was a good cop, unlike Training Day. And so it was very dear to me because it was a great role to be in.
Wow, that's amazing. Well, Denzel, thank you so much for catching up with us. Make sure you tune in. We are currently shooting seasons 19 and 20 of Wildin' Out. It was such a pleasure.
Okay, I'll be looking out. Mwah.
All right. Now, guys, wow. That was incredible. I can't believe that just happened. But I got to shout out another legend who's in the building with me. And, you know, he was planned for today. I always tell him he is the battle rap GOAT. He's legendary, not only killing it on Wildin' Out, and we actually came on the same season together. We'll get into all that, but killing it in URL. I mean, one of the best to ever do it is my brother, Charlie Clips.
Yeah.
Clippy, what's up?
What's good, T-Town, man? You know what I mean? I appreciate you, sis, you know that. You know, I don't just call you Justina, I call you sis.
That's a fact.
You know what I mean? We family at the end of the day, so I appreciate you for having me. Thank you. I can't wait to get on here. What's up?
Yeah, I mean,
I see you talking to Denzel and all that. I seen him go down the... the hall and all that.
Yeah, and what's crazy is people are already texting me, like, I cannot believe you ran into Denzel. Like, crazy that, like, my management team just texted me, I can't believe, literally, they're like, can't believe they saw Denzel, knowing what a big fan I am. It's just, it's incredible. You never know who actually you might run into in this hotel.
In this hotel,
lot of people film in Atlanta. There are a ton of studios, and you know, me and Clips we're in a place that's private down here, but we could still see who's walking,
walking by
in and out. You know, it's a little soundproof, but you never know who we might run into next. So that's amazing. But thank you for being here, Clips. And you know, I do this every Sunday. I like doing it on Sunday because Sunday is like a family day. So I like to be with the fam. And also, I'm not gonna lie, we only have Saturdays and Sundays off while we're filming. So I was like, you know, let's do it.
Tea time with Justina and football, one of the greatest combos that they...
It's a good combo. It's a good combo. I want to say congrats to Nick Cannon. I just feel like it's always good to congratulate him. That way, he probably just had a kid or has one on the way. So if we just say a blanket congratulations.
Every day, just in case.
Get it out the way. I saw Nick the other day. I was like, hey, boss, congratulations. I was like, just in case I missed one, or there's one on here.
Like, hold this one in the stash, and just, if you do have another one, just pull it out. Remember, I said.
No, he doesn't pull out. That's the problem. That's actually the problem, that he doesn't pull out. But shout out to everyone that's tuned in. Tell a friend to tell a friend. Text them. You know, send them the app, AMP. You know, AMP is like the hottest new thing on the streets right now with the radio shows. And I'm just glad to be on the ground floor and building up my show. And that's what it is. So, yeah, tell a friend to tell a friend. But it's a lot of things I want to talk about. People want to know your experience on the show. We can tell them the story how we came together the same season. We're the only ones from our class to make it and still be here standing. But before we get to that, I do want to talk about a couple things just going on, because I just want to tell the people, I know that, you know, I haven't been doing the Tea Time with Justina Valentine's wrap up because I have been filming. It's been crazy.
Filming a lot. Got your movie.
Got the movie. Wildin' Out. Yeah, it's a lot going on. The awards. You know, it's a lot going on. But I will be back doing that ASAP. So definitely stay tuned for that. And I'll be doing the yearly wrap up. I'm probably, I'm probably going to do it with the Shade Room, but I'm definitely doing it either way. So shout out to them. But I don't know if you've been looking at, you know, all the blogs and stuff. We've been busy filming. But did you see the fall that Post Malone took on stage?
You know, it's crazy. When I tell you literally seen it about probably like an hour or two ago. First of all, salute to him. I already cracked 3 ribs.
Insane.
He himself said that it knocked the wind out of him. He said that's what happened. He said when he hit the, when he fell and he hit the floor or the stage rather, he said instantly the wind was knocked out.
Oh yeah, I could tell because it looked like he hit it. And I've had the wind knocked out of me playing sports, and that's like the scariest feeling. You just can't breathe.
You can't get your you cannot catch your breath.
For shit.
Nothing.
I remember one time I lost my breath and you know, I was playing on a field and I was so scared. It was such a hard hit. I wrote in the mud 911. I was telling them to call. I guess I could have done it with my fingers, but I just wrote in the mud. It's so scary. And imagine to have that happen. Everyone's filming you. It's like, definitely give him credit.
Them situations, right? Because God bless, he's still alive. He seems to be in good health.
Yeah.
You know, he has to heal and everything. But those situations, right, are a gift and a curse sometimes. Like, it can be, it was a curse because he hurt himself. But the gift is now it's viral and he can make a song. He can make a video.
Anything. About it,
you know what I'm saying? A song called Get Back Up.
For yes.
People who fall. And
hello.
Back, you know, there's so many things that he could do with that, you know, because it's definitely going to be a meme now that he's good.
Yes.
Now that he's good, they're definitely about the meme of Post Malone all the way up. Or whatnot, you know
what I mean? And he will make the song. He got that one song of better now, better now. You gotta think yourself again. Yeah, again. I mean, in the wise words of many philosophers, you know, Jay-Z, go and dust your shoulders off. Rest in peace, Leah, dust yourself off and try again. In a wise philosopher, hailing from the BX, knock me down 9 times, but I get up 10. Cardi is BS, you know, sounds like a philosopher's name. So yeah, I think he's definitely gonna wait. Am I bugging or is that 50 Cent? Is that 50?
Funny part, I think that is. Hold on,
hold the phone. Let me see if I can hold this. Hey, yo, Fit, what's up, man? Big fan. I'm here with Charlie Clipskin. This is insane because we.
Crazy. I was just talking about somebody about you the other day.
What?
You guys must be filming season 20, huh?
We're filming Wildin' Out, but I mean, we need to get you as a guest, and I'm trying to get on one of your shows.
I told Nick the other day, look, man, you want to have me come on the show? You gotta pay me, Nick. You know I'm doing way better than I was doing last year.
Listen, this show you have, the power spin off with Tommy, like, I would be perfect as, like, his little sister or something. Like, I got a movie coming out. I need to send you a real Fit, for real. Like, I can't even believe, like, you're standing here right now. I'm sweating.
We can get you in there, man. We can get you in there. Matter of fact, we can get you a role. You do good. Hell, you never know. You might be a permanent cast member. You know what I mean?
Well, thank you so much. Like, I literally don't even know what to say. I'm a huge fan. Manny.
Hey, you're a fan. I love it. I'm a fan of you. I think you're beautiful. I love everything I'm seeing right now. You look good. Keep up the good looks, the good work.
Thank you so much, man. I appreciate you. God bless.
I'm just going to say this to all the people out there. If they don't, they think Justine don't got ass, I see you got ass.
Clips, I'm not gonna lie. What is going on right now?
And this is, you know, where they got us at, man. The stars are the stars. We stars, they stars.
No, you know what it is?
It's all aligning.
What I've been hearing is like 90% of Hollywood films in Atlanta because you get tax breaks and stuff out here. That's why we film out here.
It's definitely a great, great, great deal for your money when you film out here. As you can see, Tyler Perry got a lot of shit locked up out here. Yes. With this joint, you know what I mean? So,
like, nah, this was insane. I'm just like, I'm so flustered right now, but I'm so glad that we're live because if we didn't capture these moments. I mean, obviously we couldn't stop and take a picture. We're filming, but I always have this audio, which is insane. So shout out to all you guys that are in here and like literally living this moment live with us. Like, this is great. 50 just told me I had ass. It's great. It's the shorts. It's definitely the shorts. Like, these are them workout shorts that, like,
you can tell he watches the show.
That was insane. And I'm really trying to get on his show, so I gotta follow up on this. But okay. Wow, I am so flustered. That was so crazy. I definitely gotta say, and I wanted to start the show with this. I definitely want to send a rest in peace to PNB Rock.
Yeah, man. PNB Rock.
Man.
Pat Stay.
Oh, Pat Stay. Yes, and I sent rest in peace wishes to him last week on my first week. I literally, like, the Pat Stay thing is still so crazy. I literally woke up and saw a video on Twitter and watched it. It was like a tribute someone did to him, and I just started crying. I still can't believe.
Yeah.
Like, and I only met Pat like online and stuff, and we chopped it up.
You in tune with the sport. You know what I mean?
He was so legendary and just seemed like the nicest guy. Like, I still just, I can't get over that. And the PNB, it's so tragic.
Man, rest in peace. You know what? Because I knew PNB personally, like, not the best of friends or anything.
Just met a couple times.
Remember, we came to the show.
He came to Wildin' Out.
Played the games. We did a family reunion together and stuff, and we just vibed and we just kicked it.
You
know what I mean? And after that, too. So it was just like when he passed away, it was like, God damn.
You know what I mean?
Because you know, you don't know a person's life or whatnot. You only know what you know about them. From what I know, he was a great person, vibe, energy,
so nice. And you know, he was definitely a friend, incredible. I mean, he did a hook for me, he did a hook for Trey 2-3. I mean, just like a nice, great dude. Him and Pat Stay. So just love to their family, their friends, and you know, two legends to never be forgotten.
Rest in peace, man.
So yeah, I definitely wanted to get that off my chest and send that love.
Yeah.
Another crazy story I saw in the media was that a woman found $500 in her KFC sandwich, which I'm trying to figure. It was in bills, but
that was the best bite ever.
Ever. I'm just trying to understand, how did that happen? I think they said that
worker. What KFC stand for?
What?
Keep the fucking cash.
Literally, the crazy part is she didn't. She brought it in, and KFC was like, we're going to refund you for your meal and give you a free meal. I'm like, she should have just kept the...
What?
The $5.
They ain't giving me no tenders. They ain't giving me no KFC bowl.
She should have got tenders for life. But I was trying to... They said it was like in an envelope. I'm like, who had this, like... You know, like sometimes when you got cash in the envelope or discount, like, how folded up was it that it fit in a sandwich? Like,
you know what? Somebody probably was hustling or something, and...
The handoff didn't go as smoothly.
Yeah, something happened to that in that situation like that. But my thing is, what is KFC going to do with it? Yeah, it ain't y'all. Y'all didn't, you know what I mean, plan this or did that. So when she took the money back with y'all, what are y'all going to do? Take it up to corporate and give them the $500?
Should have literally just given it back to the woman. But, you know, she ordered chicken and got more chicken than she bargained for. Yeah, it was definitely more chicken than she was planning.
I'm ordering KFC today.
Literally. I think some money's going to come in our
sandwich. I'm about to order a $500 sandwich.
Literally. Okay, also, so it's been a couple, you know, we definitely do not promote people fighting and all that, but it's definitely been some fights in the media. Krishan Rock's dad punched Blueface, and then he knocked him out.
Yeah.
A lot of fighting with them, because don't forget... Rock also rocked Blueface's mom and sister, which is crazy. And you know, I think they were actually supposed to be guests the other day, and I was wondering if the fight had something to do with it.
Yeah, they were, and it happened the day before.
Crazy. So I'm, you know, I mess with Blueface. We actually did a track called TikTok Remix. Yeah. And so, you know, I mess with Blueface, and I like Krishan too. Like, she got that crazy energy. I was looking forward to meeting her. So I don't know. Hopefully,
they in love, and they became celebrities, and I think that they don't know what to do in this situation. But you can tell, because you know, she's been said to cheat, he's been said to cheat.
Right.
Both said they caught each other, but they won't break up.
And they're both boxers. Both have hands.
And they won't break up
for nothing.
So the love for them is genuinely there. They just young people just going through the motions and going through the problems and stuff. And, you know, they're going to make money. They're going to continue to make money together because, if I'm not mistaken, even when he knocked his father out, I believe they're filming.
For one of the shows.
Yeah, they're filming. So who's to say that's not a part of it? You understand what I'm saying?
This is true. But there was real blood. That wasn't makeup.
Yeah. So that's what I'm saying. So, you know, maybe something transpired within the filming and it just happened on set or when it was
filming. And we just see a small clip of it.
So some people are going to be like, oh, this is just for the cameras.
Right.
They really got it in. And it's a lot of tension and stuff between them. But God bless, you know, like you said, you cool with Blueface. I got a song together, TikTok remix. And hopefully they figure that shit out. And they put it to the side, man, and really get along with each other.
Yeah, no, crazy. And they're not the only ones fighting because what's going on with, like, Tory and August? I heard that they had a fight.
Yeah. So apparently they're saying that Tory, he knocked out August. August is saying that Tory and his security jumped him. Well, you know, it's always three sides to a story.
Three sides.
So you never know what really happened if he wasn't there or don't have the footage for being there, whatever the case may be. But, you know, Tory the homie, you know what I'm saying?
Tory's been on the show,
Tory the homie, you know what I mean? That's my boy. August has been on tour with us to perform.
Oh, right. That's right. I didn't really get to chop it with him, but that's right.
He did two shows with us.
I never got to chop it up with him, but he did. Yeah.
So, you know, we don't know him personally, but still cool and all. So, I hope they figure that out. Tory said, from what I heard, Tory was saying that he don't even know what August is talking about. He's like, seriously, like, dude is...
Yeah, Tory said, I seen him post, he's like, I'm in the studio. I don't know what
y'all... He said, what y'all talking about? I don't know what homie's talking about. This is crazy. Like, I don't know if he's on a promo run.
Right, but then August said that, I guess Tory said something to him like, you shouldn't have snitched on Jada or something.
Yeah, so they said that Tory had made this statement, you was the side nigga in the situation,
right,
or whatever the case may be. So if you had her, why would you even speak on that?
Right. You know what I'm saying?
Whatever the case may be. So my whole thing is, you know, I mean, that's not my business.
Right.
I can't speak on that. Or whatever the case may be, that's not my business. So I ain't got nothing to do with that.
Right.
But if, you know, if you know, the side nigga committee, you know what I'm saying? If the side
Are you a member?
Yeah. You're not supposed to say nothing in that regard.
Yeah.
You get what I'm saying? Because if you're doing your thing.
What happens in the side dude club, stays in the side dude club.
Your main objective of being a side dude, if you are one, is not to break up a happy home.
You're the side.
On purpose. Meaning that you can end up doing it because if her husband or boyfriend finds out, then you broke up the home.
Or if she starts liking you more.
Yeah. But if you as the man puts it out there, you dig what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Yeah, that can break up a happy home as you've seen what it kind of did.
Right. It did.
For a hot second.
And then Will was at the war and smacking people. You know, domino effect.
Right, effect. Yeah. Domino effect. I don't know Tory and August relationship, but I understood where Tory was coming from with that. You know what I mean? And in August feeling like, this is my business, this is my world.
Yeah, and then August felt like he had said something like, you know, I thought he didn't mess with me from his, you know, very public comments on it.
Yeah.
And then, you know, so I just didn't dap him up because of that. And so, who knows? We actually have a caller. I've never taken a caller. Let's see. Just the goon? Let's see what he's talking about. Now, let's see. I gotta see how I bring them in. I've never done it before. I mean, you know, it's people's relationships, and like you said, it's always three sides to the story. It's Tory side, it's August side, and you know, it's the truth. So you know, yo. What's up, Nick?
Yo, what are y'all doing out here?
What's up?
Hold on. Nick, we just got a caller in. Just the Goon, what's up, man?
What's up?
Where are you calling from?
Houston.
Houston, okay. Everything's bigger in Texas, huh?
Yeah.
What's going on, Just the Goon? What you doing?
Not much. I don't know. I'm kind of bored right now.
kind of bored. How can you be bored? You're listening to Tea Time with Justina Valentine, Charlie Clips, Nick Cannon. What are you, nuts? Nick, say what's up to Justin Goon.
Yo, what's up, Justin?
That's wacky.
Well, next time you call in, have a question ready to go. Have a good one. God bless. Nick, what's up, man?
Yo, he sound like he ain't want to talk to you.
He just sounded a little scared. You know what the thing is?
You know, a lot of fans are like that.
Well, he probably didn't really think we were going to pick up. But, Nick, like, you're going to gag on who we just saw.
Okay.
We just ran into Denzel and 50 Cent.
Oh, yeah. Denzel is actually here doing, he's doing, like, one of his new shows. I can't speak too much on it because, you know, I get in trouble. But, yeah, I didn't know Denzel was in town.
Yeah, and then 50 was here, and 50 said that he'll put me on the show. The Tommy Show, the spinoff.
I'm gonna leave my show and go on 50 show.
No, I'm not, Nick. I would.
No. All right. No, go ahead. I ain't tripping. Nick, 50, we love you over here. 50.
Yeah, Nick. First of all, I would never leave your show. I'm trying to get on that show too. Come on.
I'm trying to get on 50 show.
Well, let's see what's up. We actually, Nick, you know who's calling in? Steven, the Wild and Out plug. We all know.
Look, y'all talk to Steven if we're going to handle this. I might come back later.
All right, Nick.
Nah, Steve, bro.
All right, love you, Nick. Wow, this is crazy. Steven, the Wild and Out plug. What's up, man? Let's see if we got him on. I think I got to unmute him. What's up, Steve?
What's up?
What's going on? Shout out to Steven, the Wild and Out plug in the building. He is definitely one of the most loyal.
That's the homie. Steven.
That's the homie. One of the most loyal fans of the show. He damn near like family at this point. I got Charlie Clips in the building. Thank you for supporting Steve. You know, it's the brand new show. Tea Time Valentine every Sunday, 6:30 p.m. What's going on with you, Steve? What's good, man?
There ain't nothing going on, you know, doing me, you know.
Uh-huh. Well, listen, since you're such a big supporter of the show, you damn near like a, you like an honorary castmate.
Like he is a part.
Yeah, literally, he is. He's the plug. I got to ask you, I got a couple questions for you. I don't even want to hear your questions.
Lord, I ain't got nothing.
Look. Who's your favorite guest that's ever been on Wild and Out?
My favorite guest?
Yep.
Who's my favorite guest? I ain't gonna lie, it's kind of hard to choose though. I think my favorite episode was the one with A Boogie, the Wild Style, when y'all went heated.
Okay, yeah, all right, yeah, I'll take a favorite. One. That was a good one.
Yeah, especially when Clip snap.
Oh, you remember that, right?
Yeah,
you know,
bro.
Clips be snapping, it's a wrap.
On Don
whoever
Q,
on the other side.
My niggas right there, but on Don Q and A Boogie.
Yeah, man.
Now, that was a good one. Well, you're definitely going to be excited, Steve, when season 19 and 20 comes out. We've had some great guests. We got some new games, so I definitely can't wait to hear your opinion on those. But I just want to tell you, we appreciate you for always holding us down. Supporting us, and you definitely a part of the Wild and Out family. So thank you, Steve. We appreciate you. The official Wild and Out plug in the building.
Yo, salute, Steve.
All right, Steve. Yeah, now Steve is definitely the best. He is on it. He is on it. Sometimes, like if I'm busy filming something, I'll DM Steve, what I do in this episode. Steve will be like, well, you didn't talk in Smith. You did slow job. You ended the boss. I'm like, well, thank you, Steve. Steve is the best. And definitely shout out to, you know, all the real ones that support. I think my girl Nick is in here. Shout out to her. She's always holding down the fort and showing support. And that's really what it's all about. But, I mean, if this show doesn't go down in history between Denzel, between 50 Cent, between Nick running up on us, this is just... this is insane. I mean, the fans are definitely getting, definitely getting their money's worth. Sheesh. So, Clips, it's a few more things, I want to talk about in the media, what's going on. It is Tea Time with Justina Valentine, but then I have some questions from you that the people want to know.
Okay.
I asked Khan last week, and no one gets out of the hot seat, so we definitely got to talk about it. But it's something that I saw online that was crazy that I wanted to ask you about, being a guy and being a guy who's on tour and this and the third. Enrique Iglesias was doing a meet and greet. And, you know, one of the fans, you know, cute girl, was probably like, oh, can I get a kiss on the cheek? He kisses her on the cheek, and then she grabs his face, starts kissing him on the lips. And, like, I think he got caught up in the moment. I got to show you the video. But his hand slides down, and then I think he remembered what he was doing, and he did a fake push-off. Now, he's been married for 18 years to Anna Kournikova. And when you see the video, if I was wifey, I would be tight.
Right.
So would my fist.
Right.
It was crazy. So what are you doing if we're on tour? It's the meet and greet. Nick has us taking fans with pictures, and a big Clips fan says, Clips, let me get a kiss on the cheek. And then before you know it, the lips move to the lips. And before you know it, your hand is on her booty and it's viral. What are we talking about? What's appropriate? What's not?
So you say he rubbed her ass, right?
He caught a quick, you know, feel and then remembered.
Iglesias.
Yeah, Iglesias.
Not Iglesias, Iglesias.
Literally.
I looked at it, right, and I go like this. Things like that do happen. When you're dating an entertainer,
yeah,
right? Especially one who's popular like that, you know, who's a legend and icon and people's eyes. Things like that can happen. Should they? Of course not. But can they? Yeah, because here's the thing. It, for that split second, you know what I'm saying? It probably was like, man, get off. Oh my God, she got a kiss. Like, yeah. You know what I mean? It was like, oh shit, wait a minute.
He thought his name was Iglesias.
Iglesias. Put it on Iglesias. But here's what I say about it though, right? Okay, is that a sign of disrespect to his woman once he started groping and things like that? Yes, I would be sitting here lying if I said no, it wasn't.
Right.
Yes, it was, but it wasn't.
The butt was the problem.
It wasn't planned.
It wasn't
think about it. You would never do if you sneak and do your thing. You would never do something like that on national TV in front of your wife, in front of cameras. Yeah. And stuff, right, on purpose. So therefore, it was a natural reaction that he had. And guess what? We are human. We are men just as well. You understand what I'm saying? So that's like saying, you know, Justina, if motherfucking, matter of fact, who's somebody like you like that would come on the show? Give me a legend like from, you know, not nobody new.
Yeah, not nobody, like somebody that I would just like gag, like yeah, they were on the show. Yeah. I mean, you know, Tupac, I mean, obviously. But Jay-Z, Eminem,
okay.
Nas,
Is that Plies?
No, Nas.
Nas, okay, cool, Nas. So now, let's say Nas, right?
Five.
Rule the world. So let's say a Nas.
I feel on my son. I feel on my bones. Touch it, baby.
You see that thing?
Yeah.
So let's say if Nas just finished performing.
Yeah.
You at the Nas concert. You right there on stage, too, just listening. Like, yeah. Yo, this is nostalgia. I'm watching Nas. This shit crazy. Nas go to hug you. Be like, Just, what's up, Just? And you go Nas, and you go to hug, and he kiss you on the lips.
If heaven was another way,
but look
would
though,
you pack up your bags?
But look, you didn't expect it.
Yeah,
you understand what I'm saying? It wasn't something you was looking for. It's shocking to you just as well. But you smooch back on he kissed, but you like, then it's like, oh shit.
After that, I free all my bones.
Question, no, so, do you feel like something like that can happen? Now, I'm saying somebody of his caliber.
Yeah.
Because a fan, you know, one thing about you have OCD.
Yes.
So you show so much love to fans. They don't know how much OCD you have. And everywhere we go, you still hug and say hello and shit.
And then I bathe myself in sanitizer.
So you know a fan kissing you, you're not even trying to have that at all. You know
it's monkeypox. It's COVID.
Yeah.
It's flu season.
So that's why I said somebody, well, you know, like Nas or whatever, right? But my thing is, should your significant other be upset? Yes. But should he understand?
Yes.
Yeah.
Because you would never disrespect him.
So basically, what you're saying is, it's not a premeditated.
It's not premeditated, right?
Yeah. So you get less of a sentence.
Your Honor, give me my 2 months in the bin.
In the doghouse. Yeah.
Matter of fact, give me community service.
Yes, literally.
A little smoochy.
Yeah,
smooch.
Clean the house, all that. Yeah.
Iglesias.
Ass. Yeah, you get a little bit less of a sentencing.
Yes, so being
I get that. You know,
it's not premeditated. I say.
What y'all doing?
Look at
this
nigga, DC.
What up, D?
You looking out, guys?
What the hell's going on? Nothing. Man, we're live on my radio show.
Yeah.
Tea time with Justina Valentine. We do it every Sunday. Say what's up to the people.
Hey, we're going out. We're going out. We in Atlanta right now. Hey, what's going on with y'all, man? Justina, she cool. Yeah, that's my dog.
Everything's good. Shout out to DC. He's definitely in my brand new movie that's dropping this Christmas, and he bodied it. What's up, D? You know the people love you. What's going on, man? You've been killing it this season, as always. We've been roasting each other like we always do. Stay away from me, man. Back up off me, you heard? Yo, you... Yo, you are annoying. I can't stand you. But now you've been killing it. I love you. I gotta come on your show one of these weeks, 85 South, with you and Carlos and Chico.
Don't, man.
But I gotta get you definitely, you know, this week it's all about my bro Clips, but I gotta get you 1 week, you know. The legendary
I see you in a second, man. You know
I think it's a big bomb.
Yeah. Yo,
get your Men in Black worm looking at
it. Once we wrap up in like a half an hour, we should get a gut game going.
You already know I
want
to see West Atlanta shit. Fuck
to me. Like you, D. Yo, he's crazy. I think you know what? This area is good because it's so quiet, but like we're on display for everyone to see. This is crazy.
That walk, like, by when you
no, when I, no, when me and
see,
Khan
doesn't bring
Khan don't
energy.
Bring in the energy like you.
Energy.
This is literally insane. I cannot wait to upload this. To my YouTube, and shout out to everyone listening. It's every week it's going down 6:30 tea time with your girl Justina Valentine. No, last week it was just Khan, Pretty V, and Shamar. Shout out to them. We had mad fun. Actually, it's funny. V just texted me. She texted me some. For those of you that don't know, V and Clips, they've had a little fling. That's kind of on the low. Nobody knows about that. But you know, they've had a little fling or whatever. But
I dumped the.
Yeah!
Season 17.
This is so funny. Hold on, let's see. V, I'm live on Tea Time with Justina Valentine, and my guest this week is your ex, Charlie Clips. He said he dumped you. So if you want to
17, I got rid of her.
Yeah. So if you want to call in, call me on this number, and I'll patch you in because he's definitely saying he dumped you. But love you, sis. Miss you. Shout out to V. Yeah, we had mad fun, and I definitely put them in the hot seat. So. You're definitely not going to get out of that, bro. I definitely got to put you in the hot seat, but something I want to talk about is funny. Kind of talking about the Iglesias and all that. We were having a conversation, a couple of us cast members last night, and we were flaming up a new cast member, and we were talking about open relationships. Cause he was saying he had one. I don't believe him, but I just wanted to get your take from a male's point of view, like what you think about open relationships. I'll give you my take on it, but like, just what is your take in general? Is it something you're open to? What do you think about it? Does it depend? Like,
Nobody wants a significant other sleeping with anybody. You know, you want them exclusively to yourself or whatnot. You know, but I don't blame people that does that. You know what I mean? I don't blame people. Because guess what? Some people are in love but want to go play. And so, and you know, if a man tell his wife, hey, listen, or his girl, go out in the wilderness.
Mm-hmm.
You understand what I'm saying? Go in the jungle, you know what I mean? And go.
See what carcass you come back with.
Go in the jungle, climb the tree, see what you can get. You get what I'm saying? And or she tell him,
see,
you know
you
what?
I
want to do my thing. Or whatnot, so you go do your thing. I'm not opposed to that. Like, I don't think that's a bad
thing.
Oh,
my gosh. I hate to cut you off. We're going to get right back to this. But your ex is, I got Pretty V live on the line. V, Clips is trying to say he dumped you season 17. I wasn't going to let you not be able to tell your side of the story.
First of all, what up, Tea Time with Jay? First of all, clips ain't dumb shit, y'all. Right? Anybody who want that nigga, you can have because the nigga's corny. He's for like baloney, nigga. That's what he's
talking about. Nah, he smells like baloney. Is she full of baloney?
She know what it is. She know why I dumped her feet. Her feet was too dirty. Every time she danced and came in the house, her feet stayed dirty. And I couldn't take that no more. So it's over. That's it.
All right, nigga, I'll be there tomorrow, nigga. Say that shit, you heard?
I'm not going to lie. Listening to you on the phone, I think I want to get back together, man. My baby's ooh, sounding good, man.
Ooh. I mean,
you sound good, too. But you sound like... I just need you to cut down the beard. It's getting bologna sandwiches.
Oh, my gosh. Y'all just going to have to tune in to seasons 19 and 20 and next week at Tea Time to see if Clips and V, you know, can reunite, patch things back up. You know, it's only 5 days left of the season. Mm-hmm. Will they get back together? I'll let y'all know next Sunday. Okay? I think if Sis has enough Bel Air to drink, she might forget about Rick Ross.
She might.
You know, so we'll have to see what's up.
Right now, y'all. Clippy, I know you hate Jesse. Like I said, my nigga Money, Clippy, catch up, y'all.
Wait a second now. Wait a second. Clip's got two seasons. He got tour money. He's getting his, you know.
Listen. I'm about to open up some shit called Wingstar. You keep dealing with the nigga that got Wingstar when you want to get with the nigga that got Wingstar. You understand what I'm saying? I'll let you make that decision tomorrow, sweetheart, when I see you. You heard?
Sis, I love you. I'll call you when we get off the line. Love you, sis. Oh, my gosh. Shout out to Preeby. She's crazy. I literally told her, Clip's over here saying he dumped you. There you go. Clippy, Jesse, what's good? Oh, that's my sis. I love her energy. But, okay, so back to the open relationship. You were saying that.
Basically, I was just saying that. I don't believe I would do it. You know, shit got me stuttering, so that's
right.
How you know.
Right, nervous. I said, who's listening, Clips?
I sound like Pac-Man.
You sound like Khan.
I don't think that I would do it. Cause listen, man, I don't care what nobody said. Nigga don't want his wife getting shook up in a blender.
Hello?
Nigga don't want...
She might come back tasting different.
Yeah, nigga don't want Brenda in the blender.
Hello?
So my whole thing is, I don't think I would do it if my girl came to me and said, like, yo, I was in a relationship and my girl came to me or my wife said, like, yo, you know, I think we should, you know, go play a little bit. I go see somebody, you go see somebody. I'm be like, yeah, that is true. Go see a therapist. This shit's over. You heard? Pack your shit. You're right. We do need to go see somebody.
Get out of here. No, literally.
But for those who do it, I understand it, though. Because if you're going to go cheat and do your thing and your girl allow it or her man allow it, like, hey, I respect it, right? Because if you're going to cheat anyway, now it's not cheating no more.
Listen, different strokes for different folks, but that stroke could get up off my boat. Because if I had a man who wanted to cheat, I'm going to put his head through the wall.
Uh-huh.
And then, you know what I mean? He's going to see me fine on the other side of the wall.
Wild style. Wild style.
Hello? You know, I'm very, what's mine is mine.
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh. Valentine. So, yeah, that shit ain't happening.
Valentine.
But, but for, you know, different strokes for different folks. But for me, it's not going down. I'm not with the shits. For the people who do it, I feel like it's always a problem.
Hey, man.
Speaking of
up,
problems.
Slim?
What up, Slim? What's up, Chico?
Hey, I call him Slim, but his ass ain't Slim. Hey, what's up,
Chico? What's up, baby? Where you off to?
Man, I'm getting ready to go down here and just get some burgers and fries and come back up to the room.
That's what's up, man. We're live on my radio show. It's called Tea Time with Justina Valentine. I do it every Sunday night, 6:30 p.m. DC just passed by.
Fly.
Yeah, Fly was just here, and I told him I got to get on 85 South. I mean,
man, Justina, anytime you want to come on the show,
thank
man,
you, baby.
Let me know. Fly, you can't call Fly. You call Fly, man, that shit be all over the place. You call me, I'll get it done.
I already know, but
call Los.
Los, my boy, Los.
Oh, shit, there got Los right there.
Los, what's good, man?
Hey, what's going on, man? Y'all motherfuckers over here sitting in the lobby doing the interview.
Los, what's up, man? We're on my live radio show. It's called Tea Time with Justina Valentine. It's every Sunday night, 6:30 p.m. I'm trying to get like y'all, 85 South.
Man, if you don't get your little bitty titty ass home somewhere,
I love me some Justina though. I love Justina. What's Justina's up? So crazy.
What's up, Lucy? Nah, man, this is crazy that I got all these goats on the line at the same time. I got Charlie Clips. I got Carlos Miller.
Charlie ain't no damn beef. Goat.
Oh my God. That is everybody a goat, man.
Man, fuck that shit. I'm the only goat. These niggas is sheep.
Bro, you guys are crazy. I love y'all. But yo, I need you guys to come on the show 1 week. I'm going to let y'all know whenever you have time. I know you guys are booked and busy selling out arenas, but I love y'all. And hey, the fans, they're so excited to see seasons 19 and 20.
Let me know.
Hey, man, let us know anytime you want. Just we love you.
I love you guys. Clips, what is it? I'm telling you, Khan did not bring this energy last week. What's going on?
I mean, you know, it's just the spirit and the vibrations, man. You know, Khan is a midget. You know what I mean? So his spirit can only go so
energy.
High. Yeah, he brings small energy. His energy can't go but so high. You know what I mean? It's what you can do. You know how me and Khan became cool? Like,
oh, yeah. No,
like
brothers? Give us that backstory, please.
We was in Six Flags, and he couldn't get on the ride. And I had to walk up and say, this is my child. And they let him on. So ever since then, it's just been all love.
Ever since then, you've been cool, bro.
Yeah.
This is hilarious. Oh, and for everyone tuning in, make sure you tweet me if you have any questions, if you need advice. Clips is mad wise. Like, literally everyone on the cast, I always tell him, everyone is on his body. Like, everyone's always vying for his time. He's always dropping jewels. So if you have any questions or comments, use that hashtag, #TeaTime with Justina Valentine, at me so I can see it. And, you know, we'll definitely get to your questions. Shout out everyone in the building. And just know we're here every Sunday night, 6:30 p.m. And I'm going to have your faves here with me every week. That's how we do it. Again, this week, I got my brother, the URL and Wildin' Out GOAT legend, Charlie Clips. Now, Clips, I did something with Khan last week. And, you know, I want to do it with you this week. It's a couple hard-hitting questions. But I'm going to start with a fuck, marry, kill. And for you, it's going to be chicken nuggets, pizza, or tacos. Fuck, marry, kill.
All right, let's do it.
Maybe do the kill first.
Wait, hold on. You said chicken nuggets,
pizza, and tacos. Yeah.
Ooh. And fuck, marry, kill, right?
Yeah, yep.
I might gotta marry a taco.
Marry a taco. Put your meat up in that taco.
I might gotta marry a good taco, like a good taco.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Yeah, I might have to marry a taco because pizza you can get anywhere. See, pizza's a slut.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
See, I'm Italian, so I'm marrying pizza.
Yeah, pizza's a slut. Everybody can make pizza. Yeah. A person that can't cook can make a pizza.
Like, yeah, this is true.
You know what I mean? And nuggets. So I feel like tacos a little bit more special.
So I would marry a taco. Yeah, okay, yeah, okay. Yeah.
I don't see a taco really just messing with anybody.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
Okay. You're probably killing the nuggets, it sounds like.
Yeah. Because I'm a
you gonna fuck pizza. That pizza.
Listen, a pizza with extra cheese, that's some
that's
good,
wet. That's juicy.
That's a good pizza pussy.
A wordsmith, ladies and gentlemen.
That's a good pizza pussy.
That's a fact. That's a fact.
So I would fuck the pizza and kill the nuggets. Cause see, nuggets, you know. Shout out to McDonald's. You know,
right.
You know what I mean? Might be a sponsor one day.
Sponsor
you know,
us if they want.
They yeah. No
I mean, I've done some McDonald's commercials. Shout out to Mickey D's. Hello?
McDonald's, you can get your little 10-piece sweet sour sauce, barbecue sauce.
That's a fact.
Little tangy barbecue. You could go Wendy's. I like their nuggets. A couple nuggets, please, but I'm not a nugget fan. You know what I mean? So that's my list right there.
Fuck it. He don't need a nugget.
Yeah, tacos, pizza, and kill the nuggets.
Yeah, no, I'm going with the pizza all day. But oh man, speaking of birds.
What are you guys doing?
Khan, what's up, man? We're on Tea Time with Justina Valentine. I told you I was bringing the real goat this week.
Clips is bugging. He's a bird. Why are you having him on your show?
Yo, people love Clips, man. People were mad excited. Like, don't be mad. I didn't bring you 2 weeks in a row. I'm going to bring you back. Relax.
Yeah. Whatever.
We already here talking about, you know, the season. We'll tell them about the movie. All right, whatever, Khan. Go get.
I'm gonna leave you two birds at it. I love you, but I can't deal with this.
All right, whatever. Khan, look. The funny part is he's jealous.
I know.
For real.
Yo, CON, you forgot your step stool. You little fuck. You're a bird.
Yo, something's wrong with us. I'm going to tell you something. I can't do the show in this look. Well, actually, yes, I can. As long as, you know, the first few The first few people we ran into it, ran into worth it, but
The last one, no, I don't like.
And you notice how Khan, he's the most transactional. Talked to us for 2 seconds.
Yeah.
Barely said what's up. That's just how Khan does it.
Probably,
all right.
Probably trying to run and get online and
go play TikTok. Now, speaking of our castmates, I asked Khan a question last week, a hard hitting question. So take your time and think about it. Okay. But least favorite cast member of all time.
You just named them.
Khan?
Yeah.
That's hilarious.
Worst. I don't fuck with him. He's the worst. Seriously though, least favorite?
Yeah, least favorite. I mean, I know you and Khan, you know, you play fight, but your brother's
is this correct. Something you have to answer? Like, if you don't...
You don't have to, but, you know, I mean, you can. You know, I mean, you know, you can plead. You can plead the fifth.
Nah, it was this guy I was on the show who thought he was the king of the jungle.
I'm the king of the jungle.
And he was ready to rumble.
So you gotta come.
And his career took a tumble. Nah, that's my little brother. I wouldn't even do that to Royce. But I plead the fifth on this one.
Okay.
Good one, sis. Yeah. I plead the fifth.
All right.
Because everybody's dope in their own right.
Own way.
I don't have nobody that's horrible.
No, that's true.
Yeah.
And shout out Royce. He actually came through. He's back this season. Came through. Did his thing.
Did you see his forehead?
Bruh.
As a lord. He got
bump.
Yeah, he's got his forehead is pregnant.
Mm-hmm.
It's 2 minutes.
He's
it ain't even too part. Much. His forehead is 2 minutes. He got a speed knot.
Look,
like a mug.
That's God telling him to slow down. Now, for those of you who don't know what we're talking about, which you probably won't, when you see Royce on this new season, you'll see he's got a huge lump. And as far as we're not, and I'm being honest when I say, we don't know exactly what it is. I touched it last night because I was so curious. So did you. And it was.
What you think?
I think he's becoming, maybe he's an alien. I'm really not quite sure.
I think it's an ounce of cocaine.
And knowing him.
I think the cops was after him. And he didn't have no way to put it.
He took a pencil, opened that thing up and just.
And stashed it in his forehead.
And poured it in. And I wouldn't be surprised. I really wouldn't. All right, Clip. So I have a few more Wild Now questions for you. You know, people want to know. So we couldn't do your least favorite cast member.
Right,
okay.
Right.
I want your least favorite and favorite game on Wild Now. Like, if there was one game when Nick was like, Clips, whatever game you hate the most, we're going to cut, what would it be? And then your favorite game where you're like, y'all, I want to play this every episode. Right. What would that be?
I love them all, but my least. If I had to pick the least favorite one, it would probably be.
I know mine.
Ooh, that's a good one. What's yours?
Turn up for what?
Turn up
and,
for what?
And the reason why, it's a simple.
So easy, but so difficult.
It's a simple game.
Because we lyricists, so we try to get.
Correct.
Crazy, so we don't have to.
I want to get to the lyrics. I want to get to the rapping. It's like, okay, I get it. Turn up. We're happy. Yeah, we're turning up. But like, you know, for me, it's like, I want to get to the pick up and kill it.
Yeah.
I want to get to the flow jobs. I want to get to the sex flicks and chill. I want to get to wild side. I want to get to full spin. I want to get to backseat of my ride. I want to get to classroom. So like for me, turn up for what? Like, I got to listen to everyone talk about turning up. Like, shut up.
Yeah.
Let's get to the rapping games. You know, and don't get me wrong. It is a fun game. Like, we love all the games. But if there was one, it would probably be that.
That's a good pick, though.
Yeah.
I understand that. So you know what I'm going to do?
So fly.
Fuck it. I'm going to match it.
Yeah.
Let's go So Fly.
So Fly. And the funny part is because So Fly is very similar to Turn Up, but you're turning up for your team captain.
Yeah, yeah,
so
yeah.
So it's like
turn up. So Fly, yeah. I'll match that one. And my favorite, I know people would think it is Wild Style, but I don't look at Wild Style as a game. This is what we do
for real. Yeah, this is what we do for real, and it's every episode.
Yeah,
so it kind of doesn't count.
Yeah, I wouldn't look at it as one of the games. I would say my favorite, I got a couple that I like. Believe it or not, I like Got Props, Greenery, Screenery.
Those are fun.
They're just fun to do. So if I had to pick one, it would probably be.
You're creative. You're good with Got Props and the Greenery.
I'm gonna use those two. I'm gonna say it's a tie between those.
Okay, I actually love those games too, and it's fun because it's so quick. It's like you run out. You know, they give us the prop, like as y'all see on TV, they literally hand us a prop and we have like a minute to think
of. But that's because here's what I like.
We like to think quick.
Believe it or not, out of greenery screenery and got props, people would think I probably like it because of the creativity.
Right.
I like it because of the dumbness that we come up with sometimes when dumbest shit don't stuff. Hit.
Yeah.
It's the funniest shit on those because that's not like Plead the Fifth. Talking spit when nothing hits and you like, oh shit, like,
right?
It's quiet.
Or they don't spit the water. It's like,
yeah, a greenery screening and got props when you go out or whatever. Like I just did one with the little shopping cart. And I tried to act like I was going on Spirit Airlines with my suitcase to take stuff out. They all looked at me like, what?
But it's you.
But I laughed and I'm like, yo, this shit is
funny crazy. Buzzer.
Right, so I would go with got props and greenery screen. I would say it's the top.
Yeah, so. Yeah. No, I think those are good. I mean, you know, for me, I'm already, you know, I'm gonna pick the rap games.
Yeah, flow job.
Bull spitting.
Seth Flitz. Yeah. Oh, the queen of bull spitting.
Queen of bull spitting. Queen and king.
Yo,
bull spitting. Pick up and kill it.
Yeah, nobody can beat you in bull spitting. You had that down.
I definitely held the title.
The only one that
Bobby second place.
I'm about to say, was it Cortez that was holding on for dear life?
I think
who's holding on for dear life.
It was Bobby and Cortez, but I think I'll put Bobby second place and Cortez third because Bobby actually gets more bars in.
Yeah,
Cortez
is so
just
little.
He's just holding on like a fly on an elephant's back.
But that's
he just
but nah,
doesn't
you
even
have,
count.
You have bull spin down.
Yeah, no, fly. You know that. That's one of my faves. But yeah, I mean, but all the games are great, and I can't really wait until the fans see the new games this season because it's another new rap game, and then another new. It's kind of like a turn up, but it's different, and I actually like it better. What's up?
King of the jungle, I give you this banana, girl, I'm ready to rumble.
What y'all doing,
the
man?
The funniest part is we were just talking about you.
I hope it was good.
Well, some was good and some was bad. We were saying that we were so happy that you were back this season, and we were talking about King of the Jungle, and then we were talking about your bump.
I didn't see. I was happy. I'm going to be real with you. This is tea time. And then shit is hot.
I figured you would be talking shit.
I gotta give it 100. I'm not happy.
Because you're walking over.
You know what I'm happy? I'm happy. I'm happy your forehead made it back. You understand what I'm saying? Look at that shit, man.
We were just talking about how we touched that thing last night and now we're scared. Well, we sanitized our hands afterwards.
You ever watch Barney?
Yeah.
You watch yourself on film now.
Have you ever watched Barney's friend? The little green eye. I see the fuck you.
You guys are getting a live goddamn. People are saying when someone gets a shaky. What up, Royce? This is my live TV show. I do it every week. It's supposed to be on AM, 6:30 p.m. Tea Time with Justina Valentine. If you make the cut for the episodes this season, I might bring you in a couple months. I got to make sure that you make the episodes.
All right,
I'm playing. You did your thing.
I feel that. Okay. Well, I love this. It's dope, man. Hi. Shout out to everybody. It's your boy, Royce.
Oh, shout out to the plugs in the building.
Shout out the plug. Hey, you already know what time it is. Shout out the beautiful Justina Valentine. Yeah,
so
shout out Cliff. His first name is Charlie. This is what I'm talking about too.
A good setup.
You feel what I'm saying?
Where is the punchline?
I work on it.
Give us a good Charlie roast.
Charlie roast. Let's see. All right, I'm gonna roast you real quick, Charlie. Sometimes I look at you, and all I see is tits, ass, and hips. And next thing you know, I'm missing my chips. Look back up, it's a bunch of salt on your lips.
That was decent for him.
That shit was trash.
I mean, it was, but for him, it was decent.
Yeah, for him.
Should I sing? Can I sing to the people?
Go ahead.
Y'all ready? I'm busting out a real quick song.
Okay. Yeah, it's still COVID, though, so don't be, like, screaming in my face. All right.
What are you saying? Let the people know you dress like a gym teacher. Tonight!
I'm going to stop right there. That's all.
Nah, that was fire. Wait.
That's all I need. It's the afternoon, idiot. Do something else.
Shut up.
That was kind of fire, Royce.
You already know.
Still got it.
Got it. The funny part, that was not
tonight.
Shout out Justina.
No, go ahead. Get the people a little four-piece.
Give them a little four-piece.
I just wanna take you home.
Oh, wait, hold on. Wait, hold on.
Wait.
Hold on.
This is live.
Yeah, hold on.
He was not joking. We needed the auto tune.
Sounded like an Amazon.
All right. Come on. All right, do it again.
Come on, one more time.
You on Amazon? Come on, Eddie K. Hilarious.
All right, I'm gonna give you the first bargain. Hold on. This is some shit Eddie K. that nobody else does. All right. This what gets me. This is my game right here. All right.
Tonight.
That's it.
Damn, that was fire.
But all you
really got one word?
Hold on. You just can keep saying tonight. What the fuck happened?
That's
tonight?
All I need to say.
There's nothing that goes on tonight.
It's tonight, bitch. It's tonight. Let me
do this, Justina.
Tonight.
Yay, Glitz. Shit, that was nice.
What the fuck are they talking about out here?
That was nice.
What are they talking about?
Good evening.
They set this party on fire.
Woo-hoo! Okay, boys. Sheesh.
All right, I'm out. I got to get going.
Wait. Before you leave, it's a game. We literally only have 4 minutes left in the show.
He has nowhere to go.
Yeah, I know.
Don't worry.
He just want to look.
I can't
put my it's a game that me and Clips always play, and it's a game only a few people in the world could play because you have to be superb at rapping, rhyming on your toes. It's a compound rhyme game, so we want to play a couple rounds with you to see if you can do it. We're going to keep it real simple in the beginning. All right? I see you're drinking a nice drink.
You know how I roll by the block? I throw the dice, think.
Uh-huh.
Sometimes I look at Justina's face and I go, blink, blink.
You see what I'm saying?
No.
Okay. Dice, right. Blink.
Yeah, I was about to say, I went to Fashion Nova and I got a white mink because it was nice drink. He said dice, think. You only said blink. What happened to the...
Okay, let's do it over.
Let's do it again.
Royce, your life stinks.
Now go to a different. Go to you. Do the words first.
He doesn't understand how to do it. Okay.
Let's start over. Just one more.
Hold on. Where did you go to school?
I'm the king of the jungle.
Not my child.
All right. So listen.
Make sure my child never goes
there. Royce, why are you wearing a fanny pack?
Probably because I'm light skinned black.
Okay. No. So you should have said your fanny granny's pack. Whack.
On Halloween, I ask where the candy's at.
Uh-huh.
Sometimes I wish I could turn into
a granny
bat.
I see?
All right, well, that's it.
Okay, yeah. I mean, you talk so much, you're like a rambling cat.
And I go, 1, 2, 3. That's the light-skinned Drac.
No.
Oh, my God.
See,
why
no.
Why do you keep trying to say light-skinned? What do you want to be? Great? What the fuck is wrong?
All right, I think we have to keep it to two syllables. Let's do it. Okay.
Be slow. That's not on me, you.
All right. Why are you wearing, we'll do 3 syllables. Why are you wearing dirty socks?
You know me, if it's beef, I'm shooting 30 Glocks.
Uh-huh.
Oh, shoot, that means it's time to run. Somebody look at the clock.
No.
You know what, let me, I know what it is. Let me set it off. You next, Royce.
Okay.
You are dumb.
And now you're done. You're his son. Time to run.
And guess what? I had fun. Gotta go.
I still.
Bye, Royce. Oh, my gosh. He still had to think for the one syllable. Listen, this is something I want you to actually work on before next season.
Yeah.
But we love you, Royce, and we're glad you're back. Work on that. You'll be better than Lost. Okay. You know, only the strong survive. Even
only
if you're the king of the jungle. Love you, Royce. Yo, I just want to thank everyone for tuning in. We only have 2 minutes left, but I had so much fun, man.
Come up again.
You have to.
I love this show, man.
Listen,
this is fire.
Thank you so much. And the people, they loved Khan, but I just honestly think they're going to love you better. So, you know, I want to get you in. Maybe we do once a month, once every other month. We'll see what your schedule is. I know you do a lot of battles and stuff.
Think people might like anybody like 5'2" and up. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, anybody 5'2" and up. If you're under 5'2", it's quiet.
Yeah.
So maybe, you know, we'll do Con every other month and we'll bring you like once a month. Because I definitely want to get my family as like regular co-hosts to kick it with me because the people really love to hear us together and just really hear the synergy because, you know, they see us on TV, but they don't know that we're family for real. They don't know
that's
the story.
That's a fact.
They don't know the stories behind the scenes. And next time I bring you up, what I would really love to talk about is to dish a little dirt of when we go on tour. Like who stinks in the bunks, how we play the card game, how we gamble for real, like how we have stayed up all night gambling till 9 a.m. and went and did a show. Like crackheads.
Let me know when you want me back up. I'm up here. And hopefully when I come back, Royce know how to compound round.
Compound round. We'll let him call in and we'll see. If he doesn't, we'll just hang up on him expeditiously.
Okay.
But thank you all so much for tuning in. You guys know what it is. It's tea time with your girl, Justina Valentine. I do this every Sunday night.
Yeah.
6:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Tell a friend to tell a friend. Make sure you follow me and make sure you pull up. Next week, same time, same place. Huge shout out to my brother, the legendary Charlie Clips. Make sure you follow him.
Gang, at the real Charlie Clips on Instagram. My sis keep telling me to get on TikTok, so I'm about to get on there soon.
He needs to.
At the real Charlie Clips on Instagram, and that will be my name on TikTok too. Much love to y'all. Tea time on C time. It's on her time and me time. We out of here.
Yes, sir. Love y'all. See you guys next week, and I hope you have a great one. Remember to be true, be you, and if don't nobody love you, Justina Valentine do. Love y'all. Peace.